Hey guys, it's Megan Margaret here with part 10 of Let's Play Sims 4. Now, I understand we're here, like, looking at Evangeline and her undies, her little tiny whities. But it is morning. The two, Beverly and Marco, actually just came back from their late night out at Chompy's Movie Theater Park last night. They watched a scary horror film and got to know each other, just chatted it up a bit. You know, they enjoyed their night while Evangeline was working and, you know, dealing with stuff, because, you know, Evangeline, she's been seeing Dawn so much lately. Like, she's definitely falling hard and, you know, really starting to have serious feelings for this guy. And where are you going to throw this? Oh, okay, I totally understand. This water is spoiled, time to clean it up. But you know, I should know she's definitely just spending a lot of her time with him instead of, you know, with her roommates and her friends and, you know, her family here as well. So I don't know, they kind of felt lonely and they wanted to go out and spend some time together. You know, why not? Because since Evangeline couldn't join them, she was tired from work and everything. So speaking of Dawn, today I actually wanted to pay the bills, make sure that's done, so we have some electricity in this home. But also, at the same time, maybe seal the deal, because I know we're like lovers and romantic interests and stuff, but we're not really dating just yet. So I think there's a motorcycle outside my house. I don't think you could hear that because it's kind of not that loud. But buy a chef station. Honey, we don't got enough room for that. All money. So they're pretty much like, they're simoleons. Seems like they're gonna be living here for quite some time. And oh, before I continue, her birthday was supposed to be tomorrow, but I expanded their life stages and now her birthday's in 5 days, which like sucks because the other guys are gonna be in 20 days. And I did not mean for them to have two different, like, have birthdays on all different days, but it makes it interesting that way. You know, she's older, she's trying to settle down, she's trying to just, you know, I don't know, like, get to know someone, start a family possibly. Now, we're not talking about all that yet, you know, because she's becoming an adult, so maybe she's having this like crisis, like, oh my god, what do I do with my life? You know, the party has to stop, I have to kind of be committed to something. But it doesn't always have to be that way. But that's just how Evangeline envisions it. She's just like worried about, you know, what her mother used to always tell her. And since her mother is such a traditional woman and everything, you know, she kind of wants to, she's always been hearing throughout her life, you know, her mother telling her, you know, oh, you should settle down around this age, just to have children and have lots of family like I did, you know, that's how the world, the cookie crumbles, the world turns. I don't know how else to say it. But, you know, eventually I did get that, and it's always stuck in her mind now, and she's feeling like she's pressured to do something, because her mother occasionally sends her emails and sends her actual mails and stuff. You know, since Evangeline introduced her to emails, she does email her from time to time, and she sees that, and her mother comes and checks up on her, being like, hey, what's up? Where's the kids? Huh? Grandkids? No? Anything? So, you know, eventually just feeling a little mini mom, I guess. You know what I mean? But, and then, you know, her roommates are still out there partying, like, going out late nights, coming home at 5 a.m. Like, that's not really the life Evangeline is seeing to live, you know? I don't know. I don't really know how else to say it. But I want to take care of this garden before we actually do anything else. But actually, before that, before we deal with the garden, with our little family garden here, we do want to text Dawn. Just send him a quick little good morning text. Like, hey, good morning, babe, even though they're not dating yet exactly officially, but she's sending him a little flirty text, you know what I mean, just saying she had a great time and everything. Of course, you know, just so we have, it's great, always has a great time. But we have played The Sims 4 for 4 hours, 5 hours, my bad. Nice. Always getting that achievement, great, you know. So, and then after that, she's gonna just watch, since she's feeling a little romantic, and watch culinary training videos. That's so cool. I've never seen that before. I love that. Let's go ahead and watch some romance TV, since, you know, she did her chores for the day. She cleaned the bathroom, she tends it to the garden so they can have some fresh produce, she cleaned up the house while these two are still snoozing. You know, how mature is she getting? I really see it. I feel like it would be good to kind of change up their clothing. She just want to wear something a little saucy for Dawn to still kind of try to seduce him, because she is falling for that man. But at the same time, just, you know, she's feeling her age. It's getting there. Not saying an adult is like old. No, and of course not. You're still a little young and stuff, but I don't know. She's just feeling a little different. It's been a while, you know what I mean? So after her romantic television here, she's still pretty bored. She's you know, definitely a snob. She wants the highest possible quality of everything. Who is yelling outside my window? Like, what are these kids doing? I don't even know. It's what time is it? It's 9 p.m. 9:30. What are they doing outside? Where is their mother? Where is your mother, kids? Well, yeah, I think we're just gonna add an outfit to her, you know, just something else. Let's see what we could gift her, actually. So I'm thinking saucy, but cute, but maybe more mature. I don't know if I like this. I'm not really too into it. These are all like dresses and they're all kind of a little weird. I don't know. I'm not really feeling all of them. These people outside my windows are, oh, don't worry, this is something. These people outside my window are really distracting me, actually. It's pretty bad. Now, this is a very fancy, I guess. Like, she wouldn't wear that. Like, it's so, like, that belt is just, poof, just in your face. You know what I mean? It's not really an everyday outfit, nothing too casual. I don't know, maybe like a dress? Ooh, I don't know. What is this? This is sort of cute. Maybe we could give her something like this. Maybe not something too dark, because my Sims always wear something so dark. They need something livelier in their lives. I want like a pink. Like, that's a cute fuchsia color. Even though she's wearing like the same thing for her other everyday. I don't know. And then maybe we could possibly give her some other shoes. Those would not work. Let's see what I have in custom content here. Not really sure for the look I wanted to go for. This, I don't like that. I just don't. Do I want to wear heels? No, that's like too much. But not taking those either. These are kind of cute. Be in black, so they're not like too like, oh, nude would be better. But then again, heels are so much on the foot, you know what I mean? These are kind of cute, these wedges. Ooh, okay. And white. Maybe we could put like her hair up. We'll see. I think I'd rather the nude, like pink, and then the white is very too, both like bright colors, you know what I mean? So let's see what we could do for the hair. Something a little more subtle. Maybe not like this. No, I'm not feeling that. This is a cute little bun. Aww, I like that actually. But I had like some like curly hair really that I liked. Let me find it. Even though I love this bun, I don't really want braids or anything, or like long hair, like nothing long. She already has those other braids, you know. I don't really want the afro, or I mean, this is like, no, it's not her. She's more, I don't know, like she likes to straighten her hair, you know what I mean? I like this hairstyle, like just in general. Like, I kind of like it. I love the high pony. I don't know, I just need more high ponies in my life. If I put a high pony on myself, my hair is gonna hurt my head. Do you know after that? After having your ponytail in your head. What? Having your hair in a ponytail for so long? It kind of hurts. What is this? Please tell me how, like, I didn't even know that existed in my game. Is that bad? Is that bad? I forgot I downloaded that? Let's just go back to the other thing, because I really like this. I'm gonna dig this for now. I don't think she wants anything like crazy. It's cute. The dress is cute, romantic. The hair is cute, flirty, romantic. And now we're gonna do her makeup a little differently and take off those hoops, because honey, she is not feeling the hoops today. No. Maybe something cute. There were these earrings that I really liked. Were they? Yeah, I think they were these. They're very fancy. Maybe you could give them like a different, like a rose gold kind of color. I like those. And then let's change up her makeup real quick to something a little lighter, I suppose. I'm gonna try to go into my custom content here, see what I have, because I want to use the new stuff, you know, that I have, the Too Faced chocolate thing. Oh my god, I went to Macy's today and I was just looking at all the makeup. I spent way too much money on it. Yeah, way too much. That I probably shouldn't have, but yeah, okay, something light like that. Maybe take off the eyeliner. That's very dramatic. Should I wear some other sort of eyeliner? Do you know what I mean? Like a little tiny wing, but that looks like she has smushed mascara all over her lower lash line. So I don't really want that bronzer. Oh god. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. No, no. Nope. I don't like that. we can give her a different highlight. Or, hold on. Let's see. There's these really natural lips that I love. Not those. Maybe you could give her gloss. I think with this look it would be a nice gloss. Where are all my... Ooh. Okay. That's not what I was looking for, but these are pretty nice. They're cute. They're highlighted the Cupid's bow, but I want... Yeah, looks like a cute little gloss. This one I really like as well. And then I have my mouse cursor surrounding it. Oh, what is it? Circling it? Yeah, that's the word. This is... What is this? Jessica's highlight? I really like this. Or what I usually use it as for a model's one. I mean, I think we could switch it up. We could try this one for now. Why not? Try out something new. This one I like, but I just want the wing. I don't want the little inner corner to be too highlighted. I guess we could do this kind of blue. Now that doesn't really match. Makeup just takes so long, so just decide. You know what I mean? Here's a winged eyeliner look without the lower lash line being smudged. Do we like that? No, I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling it, you guys. Really hard to decide. Okay, you know what? I'm going to go into the base game and get some winged eyeliner. Perfect. That will work. Not that dramatic. A cute little wing. She's looking cute. It's spiffy. I love it. Okay, now that we are finally done. Now, the other two, they still have to go shopping for some new clothes, ordering online. They're going to see what they get. You know, they have to really, they're liking their outfits. We can imagine they have more than one, of course, you know, because I wouldn't wear the same clothes every day. These two wouldn't either. But, or these three, rather. You know, she just wanted to change her look up a bit. Of course, she's still gonna have her old outfit because I like it and it's cute. But let's go ahead and now, what could we do? These two are still snoozing away. Can we water these? No, let's evolve for garden. Go back and tending it until we didn't even realize we didn't finish. So I just want to do that and speed up through it because it's nothing really big. I just want it done, you know, for the sake of it being done and for the gardening to grow. You know how they grow as Sims and their relationships grow and they just mature and develop over the days. You know, I want their garden to do the same. And I want to move this tree somewhere else because it's like, it's bugging me a little bit that it's like not growing. I don't know if putting it back here, this is a really awkward place for it as well. These two trees just being here like this. Look at, you know, okay. Okay, all right, we're just gonna leave them because nothing much to do. But let's weed all of these guys and okay, perfect, under the little mixology table thing. What is it, the bar? I guess you could call it. Perfect, so we just weeded. We still need to weed though. What? Oh, of course, under the kitchen counter. Oh, of course, my dear, yes. Okay, that's exactly where dandelions would grow. Uh-huh, okay. All right. Nice. So now all our little garden has increased in quality. I love that. She is so bored. So what she is going to do is actually... Are those church bells? What? I've never even heard that. That is... What? That is so cool. That's not new, is it? No. Okay. Well, I want her... Oh, she's so tired. Why? Fine. You know what? She can have a quick nap. These two need to get up for the day because they need to get their day started. It's just not okay to be sleeping in this late when they have work tomorrow and they have to, you know, kind of get their duties done and stuff. Let's go have her actually change her athletic wear and she's going to go for an afternoon jog, sort of speak, I guess you could call it. Let's go ahead and have her go jogging. Now he broke the toilet, so you know what he's going to do? He's going to repair that. Because, honey, eventually he's not getting up and repairing that. And Beverly's not coming home to repair that ish, too. So no one wants to clean the dirty toilet you just broke. Mm-hmm. That's right, Marco. Yep, you do that. Okay. Now that she had her quick little nap and she's ready for the day, she is going to change her outfit into her everyday do. Please. Take a quick steamy shower. And then she's going to... That should make her 40 enough. No, honey? Damn it. We're gonna do something bad. We're gonna do something a little bad because we just can't wait. We can't wait any longer. Where is it? You can't call in fake sick? I wanted to do that. Well, I'm fine. I'm gonna take the last vacation day that we possibly could. I would call in fake sick, but what? That's not fair. What? I think sometimes, one time, my sim actually got a vacation day for taking a vacation day off. Like, they're like, oh, whatever, here's your paid. They earned a vacation day. I think that happened, if I'm remembering correctly. So after that, she's going to actually continue with her little text. She's going to send him another flirty text. Be like, babe, I'm ready. You know what? Let's do something today. I'm feeling a little happy and joyful. So, you know, he sees we're in a good mood. Maybe we should head out and grab a drink. Of course we should. I kind of wanted to go to dinner, but I don't think they're really that hungry. Maybe we can check something out later, but, you know, grab a little drink, spend some time together. Nothing too fancy. They went out the other day anyway. So maybe today, hopefully we could see the little zeal we have going on with him. Because I know he has commitment issues. Now he has a lot of, you know, Dawn life. Not really, I don't really know what his actual story is. But in our game, his story is that he's been through a lot of breakups and a lot of people. Siri, I didn't say you could turn on. Hold on. Our date just literally disappeared. Get your booty over here. What do you think you're doing? Ew, I'm never gonna use that voice again. Maybe I will, but I can't promise it. What? We got all dressed up for you. We did our hair this morning. Like, who do you think did this braid? Hmm? Do you think it took 2 seconds? No, hon. Do you know how much money we spent on this makeup? Yeah, too much. Okay, so honey, you're gonna go over here and you are, gonna go on and meet us. That's right. I don't know who you think you are. Dawn. Who you think you are? I'm just trying to get a good picture here. Like, I feel... How do I do my thumbnails? Oh, right here. Perfect. I forget sometimes. That's so cute. She's so pretty. She's glowing. Who are you? I don't want to order a drink without our date. Okay, you know what? We are a little, does he have work, actually? I think he has work. Okay, whatever. We're gonna go on a little dinner date with him because we want to. Now, where can we go? Well, there's a dinner and hotel. We could do that. Have you been to Hell's Kitchen? I think so. I should add more places, actually. We're gonna go just grab a bite to eat at this hotel. I suppose. Nothing too serious. We just want to hang out. That's all I want to do with him. We don't really want to spend hundreds of dollars on a dinner. So, you know, kind of, yeah, so to speak. I'm trying to go away from saying that because it's so weird when I'm editing my videos. I'm like, what the hell am I saying? Where did I get that from? Please. But I don't really know. Okay, what the heck? Where is he going? He has work, doesn't he? You're a barista, 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. Okay, clearly you don't have work, honey. He works 7 days a week. Where is he going? These Sims aggravating me at the moment. You know what? Maybe it's just not meant to be. Donna's been, you know what? We have to get to the bottom of this. He's telling us that he is busy and he cannot make it. He comes here and then he leaves. He suddenly has an emergency to do. Now, I don't really understand, but something isn't adding up. And why is this guy in our group all of a sudden? Or maybe his group gathering is whatever here. But something isn't adding up, Evangeline. He does not have work right now. This is not his hours of work. And we have to get to the bottom of this mystery in the next episode, because I'm really, really concerned as to why he's suddenly ditching us. Now, I'm pretty sure, like 90% sure, it's due to this commitment issues. Maybe he's thinking we've been seeing each other too many times and he's getting afraid or something. But it's really just starting to stress Evangeline out, and she has this fake smile on her face trying to believe, oh, everything's fine, maybe he's busy, maybe like his grandmother called and he can't make it. Okay, I understand, that's what he's been telling me anyway. His grandmother has been feeling a little sick, maybe he really can't make it. But then again, I've been hearing that his grandmother doesn't even live here. She lives in a different country, so maybe that rumor is true, maybe it's false. But we'll just have to see in the next episode what's really going on with Dawn and why he's straying away from us like this. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Sorry it was a little bit short, but I'm trying to get a little more videos out before I leave to vacation. And I'm really stressing out like how I'm going to do that. But I will see you all in the next episode. Any suggestions for the story, leave it down in the comments below. if you guys like something, if you guys don't, let me know. Also, any just request, comments below. Love you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.